The music you are listening to comes from a new kind of musical instrument, invented barely a dozen years ago, and made out of the same oil drums you can see rusting in any junkyard. It's called a steel drum.
This is made out of the bottom end, different notes. See what I can do on it. Find out how they are made, you'd have to take a trip down to the island of Trinidad.
Trinidad, British West Indies. It's an island about 65 miles long, population 500,000, lies just off the coast of South America. This is their big city of Port of Spain. Each year, for 2 days, these narrow streets are jammed with literally hundreds of thousands of people, singing and dancing in costume to the music of steel bands. Bands made of these oil drums, 5, 10, 50, or 100 in each band. Something of the old and something of the new, like most cities. It's a very cosmopolitan place. Huh, look at this. But one out of every three people is from East India, and that's an Indian movie there, an East Indian boy. Everywhere I went in town, the children came out to stare at the Yankee and his camera. People were unbelievably crowded in this section of town, 5 or 10 to a room sometimes. Wages in Trinidad, well, $15 a week for a good job, $10, $5 perhaps. And sunlight may be cheap, but rent and clothing are high. This faucet serves about 100 people in a small tenement house, cooking and washing and scrubbing. I kept wandering around town, talking with people wherever I met, asking where could I find a steel band. I thought I heard one. Let's follow the sound. There in a backyard were a group of teenagers. They called themselves the Highlanders Steel Band, and they were rehearsing for the carnival parade just 1 month away. In other corners of the yard were men hammering on drums, making them. After the rehearsal was over, I went over to the leader of the band. I told him how interested I was in his music and asked if he'd be willing to make me 6 steel drums which I could take back to America. We went down to the Esso gasoline depot, got the 6 barrels, and here he is marking them off. The leader's name is Kim Loy Wong. His father is Chinese, his mother Negro, his wife East Indian. That's kind of an all-Trinidad combination. He's cutting the top off with a coal chisel and testing it to make sure that it's good and flat. The next step is to heat it up on an ordinary bonfire. It doesn't have to get red hot. Kim Loy said he just heated it until the paint burned off, and he took it off and let it cool. Then you have to sink it, as they say. That is, hammer it till it's like a shallow basin. But he says you really have to put some elbow grease into it if you want to get it down. He gets every single dent out, smoothing it with his hand. This still has some dents in it, but this one has been well smoothed off. Now comes the tedious part. A very exact pattern has been traced on the surface of the drum, and thousands of taps are made with a nail punch, till you end up with a set of grooves about 1/8 of an inch wide and 1/16 of an inch deep. The children are standing on it just to steady it for him. These grooves serve to isolate the vibration, so you get a different note from each section. Now comes the miraculous part. Each section is buckled up from the bottom, and as it's hammered, you can hear it adopt a more musical low note instead of a high clang. You can hear him tuning it up from the bottom. Now he turns it over, and he has to tune it down from the top till he gets just the right pitch. They call it punging it up, and it's a hard job to do, you will find, if you ever try to make one. I see you. You have to lift it up to see how it sounds. I see. Tapping it underneath raises the pitch up, doesn't it? A man has to have a good ear to tune it correctly, and an awful lot of patience. A man can work a whole day just to get one ping pong in tune. All it's 24 notes. You hammer too hard on one note, and maybe the note next to it will go out of pitch. While he's working on this, let me tell you something of how steel drums came to be invented. Around World War II, there were laws passed in Trinidad against regular drums and the traditional bamboo stick rhythm bands. So the young people raided the junkyards, and that year they celebrated carnival with clanging and banging of garbage cans. Then some genius discovered that a dent in the bottom of a garbage can gave off a musical note, and within a few years they worked it up to a regular system. This is called a ping pong. It's the soprano instrument. Of course, a steel band also needs altos, tenors, and basses, and on the fire you see a tenor pan being heated. It's called a guitar pan. The sections are much bigger because the notes are lower. It's made in essentially the same way, however, and here he is tuning it. There's a very definite reason why the notes are in such an irregular order. It's to minimize the dissonance. He lowers the tone when he hammers on it from the top. They're making six pans for me to take back to the United States. What I wanted to do is this. I want to, not just to thank you, because thanks is not enough for all the things that Trinidad has given the United States and the world, but I'd like to give you my pledge that wherever I go with these pans, I'll tell the true story of Trinidad as true as I can tell it. And as you know, I can only be here about one day more, but your pans will be playing, I hope, all through the United States.
Instead of taking up the pans, you take me up instead of the pans. Put me in the box instead of the pans. Diane Renner could like to go up to the United States, you see?
Someday, we'll work towards it. Okay.
Well, now that two drums are made, they're testing them out to see if they're in tune with each other. Let's listen to them. Not quite in tune yet. They play many different kinds of music on a steel drum. Mambas, rumbas, sambas. They even play American popular songs and classical music too. One man puts down the guitar pan and another man sets it on his lap and picks up where the other left off. Now the man playing the melody has to be an expert but listen to the man sitting down here. He plays the same thing over and over again. It's one reason a steel drum is a wonderful instrument for an amateur who can't read music. Here, Kim Loy, the leader of the band, plays the guitar pan. They don't usually play other instruments like trumpets or saxophones with a steel band, but occasionally you'll hear the crisp rhythm of the maracas or sticks, or perhaps they'll take the brake drum off an old automobile and bang on it with a bolt. They call it a cutter or an iron.
There's the cutter in operation. I'm going to walk in and bring the microphone close to one pan and then another pan. We see what happens. Now first, the ping pong plays the lead. And the second pan just plays accompaniment. Here's the guitar pan playing a lower accompaniment. Playing the cutter. Here's the bass.
None of the members of the Highlanders band could read music, but their arrangement was very definite all the same. Kim Loy was particular about what each man played. They didn't bother that they played the same melody over and over again. They were aiming at rhythmic perfection. This isn't the end, but the beginning. We brought the drums back to the United States, and you can guess what's happened. All the children in the school where I teach want to know how to make them, and this is a scene in our backyard.